Hello students, welcome to Study Hive. Today we are studying second chapter, acids, bases and salts. In our daily life, we have come across so many acids and bases. Some of the acids we come across are citric acid in lemon, methanoic acid in ant bites, oxalic acid in tomatoes. Some of the bases are sodium carbonate, washing soda, sodium bicarbonate, baking soda that we use for the cooking purpose. But in this chapter, we are studying more systematically with their definitions, physical properties and chemical properties. Let us see the definition of acids. Acids are substances which gives H plus ion in aqueous solution. What are aqueous solution? The solutions in which the solvent is water is called aqueous solution. So acids are the substances which give H plus ions in the aqueous solution. Some example for the acids are hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. Let us see the definition of bases. Bases are substances which gives OH minus ion in the aqueous solution. Some example for the bases are sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide and calcium hydroxide. We have to see once again. Acids always give H plus ions, bases always gives OH minus ions. Let us see the physical properties of the acids. Acids are sour in taste. We have seen the lemon and other citrus fruits are sour in taste because of presence of the acids. They change the color of blue litmus to red litmus. pH of acids will be below 7. They are soluble in water. Acid solutions are corrosive. What are corrosive? They have the capacity to damage the things which in they come contact with. So let us see the physical properties of bases. Bases are bitter in taste. They are soapy to touch. Bases, while they are in concentrated solutions, they are corrosive in nature. Most of the bases dissolve in water. They are called alkalis. They have pH above 7. They turn red litmus to blue. While studying physical properties, we came across some words like pH and litmus paper. So let us study what is pH. pH refers, or pH can be expanded at potential of hydrogen or potency of hydrogen. pH always gives us the information about the concentration of hydrogen ions in any solutions. We have also come across a word called litmus paper. So what is litmus paper? Litmus paper is an indicator. So the indicators are the substances which change their color or their smell when they are exposed to We have come across while studying the physical properties a word called litmus paper. So litmus paper is an indicator. What are indicators? Indicators are the substances which changes their color or the smell when the pH or the H plus ion concentration changes. So they help us to say whether the solution is acidic or basic. Let us see few of the indicators and how they changes in the acidic and basic solutions. First one is litmus paper. Litmus paper changes its color to red when it is in the acidic solution, and when it is in the basic solution, it changes to blue color. Phenolphthalein becomes colorless in the acidic solution and a beautiful pink color in the basic solution. Methyl red will be red in acidic solutions and it changes to yellow when it comes in the basic solution. Universal indicator. So universal indicator is made up of mixture of many of the indicators. It changes or it becomes red in the acidic solution and purple in the basic solution. You have to concentrate or stress on these three, but not on this, as it is not there in your syllabus. So some of the indicators changes their smell when the pH or the H plus ion concentration changes. They are called olfactory indicators. Some examples of the olfactory indicators are clove, vanilla and onion. Let us study the relation between H plus ion concentration and the change in the pH and also acidity and basicity of the solutions. See, I have drawn a pH scale for you. pH scale varies from 0 to 14. In the middle, there is 7 where the pH will be neutral. See, from 0 to 7, the solutions having the pH between 0 to 7 will be always acidic, and the solutions which have the pH between 7 to 14 are basic in nature. You can see the yellow color will indicate the concentration of OH minus ions, and the green color will indicate the H plus ion concentration. So when you go from 7 towards 0, the concentration of the H plus ion increases. As you see, the area covered with the green increases as you move from 7 towards 0. But when you move from 7 towards 14, the area of the H plus ion concentration goes on decreasing, but OH minus ion concentration goes on increasing. So we can say that as the OH minus ion concentration increases, the basic property of solution increases. As the H plus ion concentration increases, the acidic property of any of the solution goes on increasing. Now let us see the chemical properties of the acids. Here we will study how the acid reacts with different substances. First, we are going to study the reaction of the acids with the metals. Acids always react with the metal to form salt and hydrogen gas. So, see example, H2SO4 reacts with zinc to give zinc sulfate, that is salt and hydrogen gas. So, release of hydrogen gas is seen here, but how to indicate or how to know that hydrogen gas is released? The gas released is hydrogen. How to identify that? So for that, we will do a small activity, how to identify the liberation of hydrogen gas. In this, we are taking a test tube in which we have poured dilute H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid, and some zinc granules. When they both react, we have seen the reaction here. It forms zinc sulfate and also hydrogen gas. So whatever gas released is hydrogen. How to know that? The hydrogen gas always makes the pop sound while burning. So when the hydrogen gas is released, it comes through a tube and it released here. So it forms the hydrogen soap bubbles here. When it reaches outside this beaker, we bring the burning candle here, which makes the pop sound. That indicates that hydrogen gas is released in the reaction. The next reaction what we are seeing is reaction of the acids with metallic oxide. So metallic oxides reacts with the acid to form salt and water. Metallic oxide plus acids always gives salt and water. Let us take copper oxide as the metallic oxide and hydrochloric acid. It will form salt, that is copper chloride plus water. Next reaction is reaction of the acids with the bases. Acids and bases always react to form salt and water. The salt and water which is formed is neutral in nature. That's why this reaction is called neutralization reaction. So acid plus bases always gives salt and water. Let us take hydrochloric acid plus sodium hydroxide always gives sodium chloride and water. We can see that both the reactions are similar in which they give salt and water. So what we can see, bases, here also metal oxide. So we can conclude that metal oxides are basic in nature. That's why they are able to form a neutral substance, that is salt and water. So metal oxides are basic in nature. The next one and the last one in the chemical properties of the acids are reaction of acids with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates. So metal carbonates or metal hydrogen carbonates, when they react with the acid, they form salt, carbon dioxide and water. Let us say, take two examples, that is sodium carbonate and sodium hydrogen carbonate. Sodium carbonate reacts with hydrochloric acid to form salt, that is sodium chloride, water and carbon dioxide. Metal hydrogen carbonate, that is sodium hydrogen carbonate, reacts with HCl to form NaCl, that is salt plus water plus carbon dioxide. Here in both the cases carbon dioxide is released, but how to identify the release of carbon dioxide? The gases which released are carbon dioxide. How to identify and how to confirm that? So the confirmation test for the carbon dioxide is done here through a small activity. See what we are doing, we are taking a test tube in which we are pouring the hydrochloric acid and either of these two, that is sodium carbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate we are taking, either of these two we can take, and after reaction they form sodium chloride and also water. Along with that, they produce some gases. The gases pass through here as it is closed completely with the cork. It will pass through here and it is passed again in the calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide on reacting with the carbon dioxide always form the precipitate, that is calcium carbonate. Calcium hydroxide on reaction with the CO2, that is carbon dioxide, it will form a precipitate called calcium carbonate. So what happens after reaction? The precipitate will become white, and due to this precipitate, the whole solution in the test tube will turn into a milky liquid. So that is called, that is the identification of calcium carbonate, and it is the confirmation test for the release of carbon dioxide gas. Now let us learn few chemical properties of the bases. So what happens when the base reacts with the metal? Bases always reacts with the metal and forms salt and liberates hydrogen gas. But this reaction is not possible with all the metals. With only few metals it can release the hydrogen gas. So see, base plus metals will give salt and hydrogen gas. This is called general formula. We are taking example of NaOH. Sodium hydroxide reacts with zinc to form sodium zincate and hydrogen gas is released. Next reaction what we are seeing is reaction of the bases with the acids. So bases and the acids reacts to form a neutral substance, that is salt and water, both are neutral in nature. So this reaction, that's why is called neutralization reaction. The next reaction what we are seeing is reaction with the metallic oxide. It is not possible because metallic oxides are basic in nature. They are bases. We have seen the while studying chemical properties of the acids, we have seen that metallic oxides reacts with the acids to form salt and water. So by that we have concluded that metallic oxides are basic in nature. So the two bases cannot react with each other. That's why we can conclude that the bases cannot react with the metallic oxides. In the next video, I'm going to teach you about the salts, how they are formed. Hello students, welcome to Study Hive. In this video, we are going to discuss about salts. This is the second part of your chapter 2, that is acids, bases and salts. The previous video, I have already discussed about acids and bases. I have given the link of that video in the description box. Please do watch that video also. In this video, we are going to discuss about definition of salts, the pH of the salts, about the common salt and the compounds which are produced using common salt as one of the raw material. And also we are going to discuss about water of crystallization. So let us start with the definition of the salts. Salts are ionic compounds which are electrically neutral, which are formed as a result of neutralization reaction of an acid and base. So what are ionic compounds? Ionic compounds are made up of ions. They are electrically neutral. The salts are electrically neutral. So let us take the example of sodium chloride to understand these terms. Sodium chloride is made up of Na plus and Cl minus. These are two radicals. So positively charged radical is called cation and negatively charged radical is called as anions. So let us understand what is mean by electrically neutral. Let us see the number of cation. It is 1. And number of anion is also 1. So 1 positive and 1 negative gets cancelled to form 0. So the total charge on NaCl is 0. So they are electrically neutral. They are formed as a result of neutralization reaction. What is neutralization reaction? When an acid and a base reacts, it will form salt and water. So they are result of neutralization reaction. They have both positive and negative radicals. See the positive and the negative radicals. So how do you decide the pH of salts? pH of salts is decided whether they are made up of strong acid or strong base, or a weak base or a weak acid. So when the strong acid reacts with the strong base, it will always form the neutral salts. A very good example for this is when hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH, it will result in to form NaCl, that is sodium chloride, and a one molecule of water. So sodium chloride is neutral as it is formed by strong acid and a strong base. When the acid is stronger and the base is weaker, it will always form the acidic salts as the strong acid is involved. When the weak acid and strong base reacts, they will always form the basic salts. So let us see the example for acidic salt formation. When hydrochloric acid, it is a strong acid, reacts with ammonium hydroxide, it will form ammonium chloride and water. So ammonium chloride is slightly acidic. The pH of ammonium chloride is below 7. When the weak acid reacts with the strong base, it will form basic salts. When HCN, which is a weak acid, reacts with KOH, which is very strong base, it will form KCN and water. So why does it happens? Why does they form acidic or basic salts, it is because of incomplete neutralization. Incomplete neutralization results to form either acidic or basic salts. Let us study about common salt. The common salt formula is NaCl. How it is formed? The common salt is formed as a result of reaction between HCl and NaOH. It will form NaCl. It is a neutral salt because it is formed as a result of reaction between strong acid and a strong base. And common salt is not obtained by this industrial application. It is not happening in the industry because the common salt is abundantly, freely available in the nature, in the marine and sea waters. They will take and evaporate all the water and they will get the salt. And also we will see so many deposits of the salts. They can extract and they can purify from there also. We can prepare so many products or so many compounds using salt, that is sodium chloride, as one of the raw material. Some of them are sodium hydroxide, bleaching powder, that is calcium hypochloride, etc. So let us see how the sodium hydroxide is prepared. When the electricity is passed in the aqueous solution of sodium chloride, what is aqueous solution? In aqueous solution, the solvent will be water. It decomposes and sodium hydroxide is formed. Let us see how it is formed. See, this is the setup for preparation of sodium hydroxide or caustic soda. Here there is an anode and a cathode. Anode is positively charged and cathode is negative. We have two electrodes here. One is anode and another one is cathode. We are feeding with the brine, that is NaCl, and so brine is made up of sodium chloride and water. It is a mixture of sodium chloride and water. When we feed it, the electricity passes here. Here everywhere brine will be there. So what happens? The brine, due to passing of electricity, the ions will split into, the ions of NaCl will split into Na plus Cl minus, and water will decompose into NaH plus and OH minus. So we can see that they have some charge on them. So always negative charge moves towards positive charge, and positive charge will move towards negative charge. That is, opposite charges will always attract. So we can see that Na plus will move towards the negative charge, that is towards cathode. OH minus will also move towards the cathode. But chlorine, Cl minus and H plus will move towards the anode. So that's why we see that chlorine gas is produced in the anode and hydrogen gas is produced in the cathode. So this chlorine gas is used for water treatment and also the water cleaning the swimming pool waters and producing of PVC and disinfectant, and it is also used in the CFCs and also used in the preparation of pesticides. What about hydrogen? Hydrogen gas is used as a fuel, and also it can be used in the preparation of NH3, that is ammonia. Again, the ammonia can be used in the preparation of fertilizers. Then NaOH is formed and it is released through this opening. So what is the reaction that is happening here is NaCl plus H2O, after passing of electricity, NaOH is formed and chlorine gas is formed and hydrogen gas is formed. So hope this is clear. See, here you can see chlorine is also produced and also some alkali product. Alkali product is also produced here. So it is called chloralkali process. Because of this reason, it is also called as chloralkali process. The next product we are going to study is bleaching powder, CaOCl2. It is also called as calcium hypochloride or calcium oxychloride. So how do we prepare this one? See, after producing this caustic soda, we have seen that chlorine is produced here as a waste product. It is not used here. The main product we want was NaOH. We have got from here, but it is a waste product. So that's why what we are doing, we are using this same chlorine in the production of bleaching powder. when the calcium hydroxide, that is slaked lime, the calcium hydroxide is called slaked lime, acted with the chlorine gas, it produces calcium hypochlorite and also water. The bleaching powder is used for bleaching of cotton, and it is a strong oxidizing agent, and it is used in the chemical industries as an oxidant, and also it is used in cleaning the drinking water. It makes the germs die because it is a strong oxidizing agent. It can kill the germs in the drinking water, so it is used as a cleaning agent in the water also. So next product what we are seeing is baking soda with the formula NaHCO3. The baking soda is commonly used in a cooking process. So NaCl plus H2O plus CO2 plus NH3 will give NH4Cl, ammonium chloride, and also NaHCO3, that is baking soda. The uses of the baking soda are, it is used in the preparation of sodium carbonate. Next, we can use the same baking soda in the preparation of sodium chloride, that is Na2CO3. It is also called as washing soda. We will see that. So it is also used in the cooking process as a raising agent in the baking industry, in the bakeries. Next, we are seeing washing soda Na2CO3.10H2O. When baking soda, that is NaHCO3, is heated, it will give Na2CO3. The same Na2CO3 is added with 10 molecules of water to form washing soda. What is the use of washing soda? Washing soda can be used in the soap making industries, and also it is used in the glass and paper industries. And also it is used in the removal of hardness of the water. It is used in the preparation of borax also. Next, we are going to study water of crystallization. Before going to its definition, let us do a small activity. Let us take copper sulfate, which is blue in color, sky blue color. When we heat it, it will turn into a decolor. The color of the copper sulfate changes. It will turn pale. And also we see that the water molecules are in the test tube. So what do we understand by this? Copper sulfate is a salt. It contains some amount of water. After heating it, the water vapor comes out, and it is there on the test tube, inner surface of the test tube, and the color of the copper sulfate has changed. This same decolorized copper sulfate, it is added with the water again. After that, you will see that color has again reappeared. So by this we can understand that all the salts contain some amount of water in them, which is called as water of crystallization. This is called water of crystallization. Let us see the definition. It is fixed number of water molecules present in one formula unit of salt. In one formula unit of salt, there is some number of water molecules present. It is called water of crystallization. Some of the salts which contains water are gypsum, plaster of Paris, copper sulfate, etc. Let us see the plaster of Paris. Plaster of Paris has the formula CaSO4.5H2O. Then gypsum is produced using the plaster of Paris. We'll add 1.5 molecules of water to form CaSO4.2H2O. So we have seen that half H2O. How does a molecule contains half H2O? Is it possible to have half H2O? No, it is not possible to have half a molecule. But how half H2O is written here? So it indicates that, see here I have drawn one molecule of calcium sulfate, another molecule of calcium sulfate. These both the molecules shares only one water molecule. That's why each contains half and half molecule of water. You can see here, this has half a molecule of water. This also has half a molecule of water. That's why we have to write CaSO4 half H2O. One molecule of calcium sulfate can have half molecule of water. So this was the end of the session. If you have any doubts, please do comment in the comment box. Please subscribe to my channel, share with your friends, and like the videos. If you really like the videos, please hit the like button. Thank you.